29th November, Wednesday.
Father, into your coats I will enter, maker of heaven and earth, I tremble in your holy presence. Glory, glory in your sanctuary, splendor and majesty, Lord, before you. All the earth will declare that your love is everywhere. The fields will exalt, seas resound. You're the dream, just a cry, praising you, and so will I. Lord, I will glorify and bless your holy name.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us pause for a moment and pray for the departed souls for whom this Gregorian Mass is offered.
Let us pray for the following intentions during these Gregorian Masses. Family members offer this Mass for the departed soul of Basani Kasparedi. Family members offer this Mass for the departed soul of Gade Rojamary. Family members offer this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. Joy John Lopes. Family members offer this Mass for the departed soul of Sister Olga Lopes. Mr. Owen Somasundaram offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. Lionel Somasundaram. Family members offers this Mass for the departed soul of Gabadari Raja Rao. Family members offers this Mass for the departed soul of Gabadari Sundari. Vijay Varghese offers this Mass for the departed soul of Anna Saheb Mohiti. Deborah offers this Mass for the departed soul of Virginia John Fernandez. Anthony Vincent offers this Mass for the departed soul of Nicholas Vincent. Anthony Vincent offers this Mass for the departed soul of Dorothy Vincent. Family members offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. I. F. Vincent. Mr. Ani Desi offers this Mass for the departed soul of all the abandoned babies. Jayamala Vincent offers this Mass for the departed souls in the purgatory. Ligori Pinto and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Jacinta Pinto. Ms. Geeta Fernandez offers this Mass for the departed souls of Mr. James and Kanta Solanki. Ms. Geeta Fernandez offers this Mass for the departed soul of deceased friends and family. Ms. Geeta Fernandez offers this Mass for the departed souls in the purgatory. Anju Santley D'Souza offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. Stanley Maxi D'Souza. Miss Ancilla Jacinta Matias offers this Mass for the departed souls of all souls in purgatory. Miss Ancilla Jacinta Matias offers this Mass for the departed soul of Emmanuel Salvador Matias. Miss Ancilla Jacinta Matias offers this Mass for the departed soul of Concepta D'Souza. Paidimalla Prakash Babu and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Paidimalla Dharmaraju Master. Paidimalla Prakash Babu and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Paidimalla Purna Teja. Presi family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mrs. Annie Mary Perse. Perez family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. Joachim Francis Perez. Perez family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. Oislin Perez. Perez family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mrs. Flora Perez. Perez family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. Gilbert Perez. Sally Lazarus offers this Mass for the departed soul of Maria Antonieta Joana de Costa. Anancia Paul D'Souza offers this Mass for the departed soul of Paul Sebastian D'Souza. Monterio family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Gabriel Pascal Monterio. Simi offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. Davis. Simi offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mrs. Maris. Mrs. Gemello Robin offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mr. K.P. Thomas. Y. Sudhakar Reddy, Asunta and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Kambam Raphael Reddy. Matai and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Philip Akarthara. Paul Rodriguez offers this Mass for the departed souls of all the family members. Y. Sudhakar Reddy, Asunta and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Y. Veera Reddy. Sanjeev and Lithi offers this Mass for the departed soul of Erupakatu family members. Sanjeev and Lithi offers this Mass for the departed soul of Karimbammakal family members. Sanjeev and Lithi offers this Mass for the departed soul of Molail family members. Sanjeev and Lithi offers this Mass for the departed soul of Pulikal family members. Mrs. Maria Joseph D'Souza offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mrs. Laurentia F. D'Souza. Janet Marcus offers this Mass for the departed soul of Marcus Mas Bijeng Singh. Janet Marcus offers this Mass for the departed soul of M. Doris. Janet Marcus offers this Mass for the departed soul of Jacob Marcus. Cecilia Marcus offers this Mass for the departed soul of Christopher Gerard Raj. Emilia Frederick DiMello and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Michael Paided Rodriguez. Emilia Frederick DiMello and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Lourdes Jospin Rodriguez. Frederick Emilia DiMello and family offers this Mass for the departed souls of DiMello family members. Supriya and Shashi Bhushanam Reddy offers this Mass for the departed soul of Kambam Mary. John and family offers this Mass for the departed soul of Blasius. Surya Baby and offers this Mass for the departed soul of Mrs. and Mr. Baby. Surya Baby offers this Mass for the departed souls of Mrs. and Mr. C.G. Surya Baby offers this Mass for the departed soul of Sister Silma. Cheryl, Margaret and Floyd Lefray offers this Mass for the departed souls of all the family members. Lorna Moyes and Pamela Quadros offer this Mass for the departed souls of sons of Malcolm Quadros. Lorna Moyes and Pamela Quadros offer this Mass for the departed souls of sons of Donald Pinto. Lorna Moniz and Pamela Quadros offer this Mass for the departed souls of sons of Albert Pinto and family. Amala Benjamin offers this Mass for the departed soul of M.B. Jospin Mary. F.N.V. Gomes offers this Mass for all the departed souls in the purgatory. F.N.V. Gomes offers this Mass for all souls in the purgatory. Let us pray for these intentions during this Holy Eucharist.
Dear brothers and sisters, we continue to read from the book of Daniel. Today, the son of Nebuchadnezzar, Belshazzar, who found that the vessels brought from a Jerusalem temple seems to be attractive. In his drunken and arrogant mood, he wanted to use them and where the holy things are used for the abusive activities, and finally the punishment comes upon him. And to interpret that, he needs Daniel, and Daniel, though he was offered so many gifts, he refused all of them and said, you can give to somebody else, but to my part, I just shall interpret to you. And his wisdom is once again explicitly shown to who the king. The king would knew that the death would be sure. Let us pause for a moment and see. In our life too, a time where maybe out of overjoy, what kind of promises do we make? What kind of life are we going to live? Are we going to cause a destruction to the people and the innocent? Or are we going to save ourselves and our soul? Let us feel sorry for all the times where we have sinned against God and neighbor. And with contrite heart, let us say, I confess to you, Almighty God,
my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my faults, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, a virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Stir up the will of your faithful, we pray, O Lord, that striving more eagerly to bring your divine work to the fruitful completion, they may receive in a greater measure the healing remedies your kindness bestows. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The fingers of human hand appeared and wrote on the wall. First reading, a reading from the prophet Daniel, chapter 5, verses 1 to 6, 13 to 14, 16 to 17, and 23 to 28. In those days, King Belshazzar made a great feast for 1,000 of his lords and drank wine in front of the 1,000. Belshazzar, when he tasted the wine, commanded that the vessels of gold and of silver that Nebuchadnezzar, his father, had taken out of the temple in Jerusalem be brought, that the king and his lords, his wives and his concubines might drink from them. Then they brought in the golden vessels that had been taken out of the temple, the house of God in Jerusalem, and the king and his lords, his wives and his concubines drank from them. They drank wine and praised the gods of gold and silver, bronze, iron, wood and stone. Immediately the fingers of a human hand appeared and wrote on the plaster of the wall of the king's palace opposite of the lamp stand. And the king saw the hand as it wrote. Then the king's color changed and his thoughts alarmed him. His limbs gave away and his knees knocked together. Then Daniel was brought in before the king. The king answered and said to Daniel, "You are that Daniel, one of the exiles of Judah, whom the king my father brought from Judah. I have heard of you that the spirit of the gods is in you, and that light and understanding and excellent wisdom are found in you. I have heard that you can give interpretations and solve problems. Now, if you can read and writing and make known to me its interpretation, you shall be clothed with purple and have a chain of gold round your neck and shall be the third ruler in the kingdom." Daniel answered and said before the king, "Let your gifts be for yourself and give your rewards to another. Nevertheless, I will read the writing to the king and make known to him an interpretation. You have lifted up yourself against the Lord of heaven, and the vessels of his house have been brought in before you, and you and your lords, your wives and your concubines have drunk wine from them, and you have praised the gods of silver and gold and bronze, iron, wood and stone, which do not see or hear to know, but the God is whose hand is your breath, and whose are all your ways you have not honored." Then from his presence, the hand was sent, and this writing has inscribed. And this is the writing that was inscribed. Mene, mene, tekel, and parsin. This is the interpretation of the matter. Mene, God has numbered the days of your kingdom and brought it to an end. Tekel, you have been weighed in the balances and found wanting. Peres, your kingdom is divided and given to the Medes and Persians. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response? Sing praise to him.
Sing praise to him.
And highly exalt him forever.
And highly exalt forever.
Bless the Lord, sun and moon. Sing praise to him and highly exalt him forever. Your response? Sing praise to him.
Sing praise to him.
And highly exalt him forever.
And highly exalt him forever.
Bless the Lord, stars of heaven. Sing praise to him and highly exalt him forever. Your response? Sing praise to him.
Sing praise to him.
And highly exalt him forever.
And highly exalt him forever.
Bless the Lord, all rain and dew. Sing praise to him and highly exalt him forever. Your response? Sing praise to him.
Sing praise to him.
And highly exalt him forever.
Him forever.
Bless the Lord, all winds. Sing praise to him and highly exalt him forever. Your response? Sing praise to him.
Sing praise to him.
And highly exalt him forever. Bless the Lord, fire and heat. Sing praise to him and highly exalt him forever. Your response? Sing praise to him.
Sing praise to him.
And highly exalt him forever. Bless the Lord, winter, cold, and summer heat. Sing praise to him and highly exalt him forever. Your response? Sing praise to him.
Sing praise to him.
And highly exalt him forever.
And highly exalt him forever.
सर्वसृष्टि के मालिक तुम्ही हो सर्वसृष्टि के रक्षक तुम्ही हो करते हैं तुझको सागर प्रणाम गाते हैं तेरी गुणगान
with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 21, verse 12 to 19. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "They will lay their hands on you and persecute you, delivering you upon to our synagogues and prisons, and you will be brought before the kings and governors for my name's sake. This will be your opportunity to bear witness. Settle it therefore in your minds, not to meditate beforehand how to answer. For I will give you a mouth and a wisdom which none of your adversaries will be able to withstand or contradict. You will be delivered up even by the parents and brothers and relatives and friends, and some of you they will be put to death. You will be hated by all for my name's sake, but not a hair of your head will perish. By your endurance, you will gain your lives." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, as I have shared my thoughts in the introduction, in the first reading we hear the Nebuchadnezzar's son, how he behaved and how Daniel has given his interpretation. Just imagine if we are also given a chance, or we also get a dream, or rather if God's hand were to come and write something in front of us, speaking something about the sinful life or the strange things or about our second coming, what is our feeling would be? At least Nebuchadnezzar's sons had Daniel to interpret. What about our life? In John chapter 8 verse 1 to 10 we read the passage about a woman caught in adultery. And all the people wanted to put Jesus into trouble, keeping the poor woman in front. Jesus writes something and none of them were dared to ask what it is or what do you see. When they said, what do you see? Jesus himself answered, the one who has not sinned, put the first stone. Maybe to our lives too, before our death comes. Am I clear enough with all my sins? Am I able to live a good and a proper and a holy life? In the gospel, the Lord reminds to the holy people where people will be. The moment you speak the truth, people will drag you to the courts. People will put you several questions. Let us take example of John the Baptist. He was speaking the truth, but because he spoke the truth, later the opportunity was sought after and he was beheaded. Paul, who before he realizes the value of Christ, he was persecuting the church. But once God has chosen him as his instrument, as we read in Acts chapter 9 verse 16, then later on so many situations where people come and try to kill him. And he gets an opportunity several times, especially in Acts chapter 23, we find how he was brought in front of the Sanhedrin and was asked to show his own interpretations. And as we have read, the Holy Spirit would help. The Holy Spirit helped him, because the same Holy Spirit, when the group of people were sitting and praying in Acts chapter 13 verse 2, we find, set apart for me Paul and Barnabas. So the Holy Spirit is in him. The same Holy Spirit has guided him. In the same way, he was able to show to the world what God is, or to whom he believes. And both the readings indication to us, especially to the brothers and sisters who have gone before. We may also, in our arrogance, we may say something. Nebuchadnezzar's son, in his drunken mood or in his violent way, he ordered those vessels to be brought in. The same thing happened to Herod too. Herod also, in his drunkenness on his birthday party, when a woman danced and he was able to promise, and then later he receives a consequence. Luke chapter 23, when he was eager to see Jesus, he expected a miracle from Jesus, but Jesus remained silent. Therefore, dear brothers and sisters, when we are brought in front of God's judgment throne, if the Lord does not speak on our behalf, where would our soul be? Where will be? We'll be feeling the torment in the heaven, in the hell. So therefore, dear brothers and sisters, as we continue to participate, let us pray for all our brothers and sisters for whom this Holy Eucharist is offered.
My days to you, lifting sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life.
Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the sacred offerings which you at your binding we dedicate to your name, and in order that through these gifts we may become worthily of your love, grant us unfailing obedience to your commandments, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just and our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, and the resurrection of the dead. Through him the hosts of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Majesty, worship is majesty. Jesus who died, now glorified, King of all kings.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Paul Antony, Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection. Let us remember all the departed souls. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Apostles, Saint Joseph, Saint John Bosco, Saint Antony, Saint Rita, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, let us dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called for the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Singing, I love you, Lord. Singing, I love you, Lord. Singing, I love you, Lord. I love you. In a moment like this, I sing out a song. I sing out a praise song to Jesus. In a moment like this, I lift up my hand. I lift up my hands to the Lord. Singing, I praise you, Lord. Singing, I praise you, Lord. Singing, I praise you, Lord, I praise you.
Let us pause for a moment and pray the Litany of the Saints for the departed souls. Litany of the Faithful Departed. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Our response is, have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed. God the Father of heaven,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
God the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
God the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on the souls of the faithful departed.
Our response is, pray for the souls of the faithful departed. Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
Saint Michael,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you angels and archangels,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you orders of our blessed spirits,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
Saint Joseph,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy patriarchs and prophets,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy apostles and evangelists,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy martyrs,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy bishops and confessors,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy doctors,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy priests and Levites,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy monks and hermits,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you holy virgins and widows,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
All you saints of God,
pray for the souls of the faithful departed.
Be merciful.
Spare them, O Lord.
Be merciful.
Graciously hear us, O Lord.
Our response is, O Lord, deliver them. From all evil,
O Lord, deliver them.
From the rigor of your justice,
O Lord, deliver them.
From the power of the devil,
O Lord, deliver them.
From long enduring sorrow,
O Lord, deliver them.
From cruel flames,
O Lord, deliver them.
From terrible, horrible darkness,
O Lord, deliver them.
From dreadful weeping and wailing,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your holy nativity,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your most sweet name,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your most profounded humiliations,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your infinite love,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your bloody sweat,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your scourging,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your crowning with thorns,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your carrying of the cross,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your most cruel death,
O Lord, deliver them.
Through your holy of wounds,
O Lord, deliver them.
Our response is, we beseech you, hear us. We sinners,
we beseech you, hear us.
In the day of the judgment,
we beseech you, hear us.
You who forgave Magdalene and did grant the prayer of the thief,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you would be pleased to deliver the souls of our parents, relations, friends, and benefactors from all the pain of hell,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you would be pleased to have mercy on those of whom no special remembrance is made on earth,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you would be pleased to grant them all the pardon and remission of our sins,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you would be pleased to receive them into the company of the blessed,
we beseech you, hear us.
King of lawful majesty,
we beseech you, hear us.
Son of God,
we beseech you, hear us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
grant unto them eternal rest.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
grant unto them eternal rest.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
grant unto them rest everlasting.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
From the gate of hell,
deliver their souls, O Lord.
O Lord, hear my prayer.
And let my cry come unto you.
Let us pray. O God, the Creator and the Redeemer of all the faithful, grant unto the souls of your servants, departed, the remission of all their sins, that by the pious supplications they may obtain the pardon which they have always desired. Grant this, O God, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
O eternal God, who, besides the general precepts of charity, has commanded a particular respect for parents, kindred and benefactors, grant, we beseech you, that as they were the instruments by which your providence bestowed on us our birth, education, innumerable other blessings, so our prayers may be the means to obtain for them a speedy release from their excessive sufferings and admittance to your infinite joys. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
And let the perpetual light shine upon them.
May they rest in peace.
Amen.
Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that those to whom you give the joy of participating in the divine mysteries may never be parted from you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Into my heart. into my heart, come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come in today, come in to stay, come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Into my life, into my life, come into my life, Lord Jesus. Come in today, come in to stay, come into my life, Lord Jesus.